Thank you, Mr. Vice Chairman, sir.
This is true. Historical fact.
Exactly after 100 years, the Jallianwala massacre incident. And after nearly 68 years, the first bill was introduced. We are again introducing this bill with some amendments. Sir, from my childhood onwards, one of the aspirations of myself was to go to Jallianwala Bagh and see the site. Because what has been taught at school and what we have read about the freedom movement and especially the Jallianwala Bagh massacre, and as everyone pointed out, the Uddham Singh and my lifetime hero Bhagat Singh, when he was a schoolboy, when he was returning after the massacre, since he has heard from his parents and the place where he was living, he collected the soil with blood stain, kept it in a bottle, and it was in his table all the time since his 9th year. And that made him to be the greatest hero and the greatest fighter and the greatest person who never yielded to anything. So all these things has prompted me to go to that place. When I first had an opportunity, I was literally upset, rather shocked. That place, instead of being maintained as a historical site, which turned the national movement or the fight for the freedom, it has become a tourist spot. People just come and go there, and especially the well where the people were forced to jump in, so many died. So though there is no official statistics about how many died, but there are details that 379 people were killed and 1,200 were wounded. So most of them jumped into the well, and one after one they jumped on the other, they died and wounded, and that well is now guarded with some granite stones. People come there, buy some snacks, they eat and go off. See, this is not the sentiment which we have to imbibe in the minds of our young generation, the posterity. You go to the foreign countries and see how they are maintaining their monuments, their historical sites. If something has happened, it should remain so. In the parliament, when the terrorist attack has happened, still there are bullet marks in the first gate. We can see that in the pillars. But you go and see in the Jallianwala Bagh, so many shots have been fired at, no trace is there. The well is totally changed. And as everyone suggested, there are no boards or anything describing the sacrifice of all those people. So what I would suggest is, before you change the trusteeship or the trust and all, you have to concentrate in bringing back the Jallianwala Bagh site as it was, and once anyone goes there, should come back being reminded of the freedom struggle and the sacrifice that has been and the bloodshed. Sir, no, we cannot imagine. So I would like to tell one important. There was one Ali Amsa in Burma. In the 1940s, when Netaji Subhash Chandra Bose was forming the INA and going around, he was collecting money for his struggle, and he was magnanimous enough to give a blank check. But Netaji took only 2 lakh rupees in the year 1940, 2 lakh, now it is crores of rupees. Later that Ali Amsa came back as a repatriate, and some 1 month before, his family came for a sum to some people, and some NGOs are helping that family. So a person has donated 2 lakh rupees for the freedom struggle in 100 years nearly ago. Now his family is starving like that. Those people have sacrificed their life in the Jallianwala Bagh massacre. They should be taken care of.
Thank you.
And their family should also be in this bill, sir. 3 amendments are here. One we can accept because it says the term of the trusteeship is 5 years. And the Lok Sabha, either leader of the opposition or the leader of the biggest party will be the member. And if the Lok Sabha gets dissolved, of course, his term has to expire. So it could be, as soon as the term of the leader of the opposition in Lok Sabha expires, his trusteeship will also expire. But the government takes the power that they can terminate any member from the trusteeship. So it may lead to authoritarianism. And so also, as everyone suggested, we cannot see the freedom struggle without the participation of the Congress party.
Thank you.
Sir, Mr. Pradeep Singh very well pointed out, please be magnanimous. He never spoke hard words. I also suggest the same. Kindly don't bring politics in such things. History should be history. If you don't rewrite history, you can write history with few more points, but not taking away anybody else.
Thank you.
So this thing, removing the Congress president and termination at any point of time, we cannot accept, sir. But at the same time, I urge the government, one moment, I urge the government to maintain the Jallianwala Bagh site as it is, as it was, and it should create a feeling of patriotism in the minds of the youngsters. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Very good.
Being vice chairman, you are not maintaining the time there.